Hi, my name is Chris Williams, Enterprise Consultant for Green Pages, and I recently attended the US VMworld last week, and these are a couple of the things that I learned about. So AppDefense is a new offering from VMware, and it's modeling itself after as a security offering, and what it's going to do is it is going to monitor the steady state of your servers. It's going to take a look at what applications are talking to what other applications inside and outside of the respective VMs, and it's going to get a baseline. And this baseline is going to then be measured against future state. So if a server becomes infected and an application then starts communicating with a different point than it has historically communicated with, there are several remediation things that AppDefense can do. It can shut down the VM, it can block the ports, it can freeze the entire environment. There's going to be a lot of hooks with AppDefense into things like NSX and VRA and VRO. So there's going to be a lot of flexibility in what AppDefense will allow you to do to the environment. One of the things that I mentioned previously when they finally announced AppDefense was what took them so long. VMware is uniquely positioned to use their knowledge of the environment, their knowledge of the VMs and the communication patterns between the VMs to do exactly this, to see how things are running, to make modifications to the environment, and to proactively clamp down on rogue agents in the environment. I think that this is the absolutely the right move for VMware to do. It's been a long time coming, and I think that this has given them new energy in the field. So I'm very excited to see what AppDefense is going to be bringing in the future. Another offering that VMware gave to the table, gave to us, was NSX Cloud. NSX Cloud is positioning itself as an NSX offering that is going to be able to natively utilize public cloud. To run things natively in public cloud. So you can use NSX Cloud to run and monitor and manage and maintain, from a network perspective, EC2 instances in AWS. And we're not, to be clear, we're not talking about vSphere on AWS, we're talking about AWS native. So I'm also interested in seeing how this goes. One of the holy grails of the customer demand right now is for the ability to move workloads from their on-premises environment, their data center, up to AWS, and then over to Microsoft, and then potentially over to Google Cloud, without a hiccup. That is the end goal that everybody wants. That's the customer demand. The job now of VMware and AWS and Microsoft and Google is to bring that to fruition, to figure out how to do that. I think that NSX Cloud is a good step in the right direction to accomplish that. All in all, it was a very positive and energetic VMworld. I liked it from the fact that you could. I've been to several VMworlds. I've been to like six or seven of them now, and this one I want to say had the most energy, because it sounds like VMware now has a direction. It felt like they were swimming around a little bit for the past couple of years, with the advent of AppDefense, with the advent of the new offerings in VRA, with a lot of the third-party plugins that are coming, with the decommissioning of vCenter. That was a big one. Now vCSA, after the next iteration of vSphere, vCSA is going to be the only way to run it. They're getting rid of vCenter on the Windows box. They're picking a direction. They're actually picking a direction for the ship to sail in. And I think that's fantastic. And I think that the businesses have responded correspondingly, as has been shown with the stock jump. VMware seems to have picked itself up and is figuring out where its place is in the new multi-cloud environment. And my opinion is that they're positioning themselves appropriately as kind of the control center for the local on-premises workloads, with hooks into everybody and being able to move things back and forth, or at least starting down the path of being able to do that. Thank you very much, and have a great day.